Hi, I'm Dr. Deb Sandella, founder of the RIM Institute and author of Goodbye Hurt and Pain. I'm here today to share with you two simple ways to release emotion from your body. So emotion is constantly happening in the body. We have emotions every minute of every day. We're just not aware of most of them unless we focus on it. And so the intention for emotion is to come into the body, to give us feedback about how we're feeling, both internally and maybe in relationship to what's around us, and then to flow on out. So emotion is meant to be transient, not permanent. So when it comes in, and we resist it, like we don't like it, we're trying to control it, we're trying to stop it, it's like creating a dam that the emotion then butts up against. And when that happens, the feelings that we're wanting to go away actually stay right here because the dam is holding them close to us, so close that it's really right inside our body. So the body then is the place where we must go to really release deep emotion. So there are three ways that we can physically express emotion that allows it to leave the body. So one is in speaking, writing, and then physical movement. So the two activities I'm going to share with you today, one is writing. That whenever you find yourself in a situation where you're feeling uncomfortable, you may not even know this specifically what you're feeling, or you may have just been in a situation where you got angry or you got hurt, whatever it is, or you may not know. You may just be restless. It doesn't really matter. Then you just take a moment. And taking it as quickly as possible, get a pen and a piece of paper, and it can be a scratch piece of paper, it could be the back of a magazine, it doesn't matter, because it's not important to be able to read what you write. What is important is that you are expressing in a physical way what the emotion is. And as you write, you want it to be completely uncensored, and expressing very strongly whatever the emotion is. So for instance, when my husband had back surgery and I was in the waiting room, I found myself feeling really sad, and I didn't understand. My head, my mind was like, well, why are you sad? There's nothing to be sad about. We haven't heard any bad news. And as I sat there, I began to write to try and get clarity. And I did use a magazine because I hadn't brought any paper. And as I wrote, and my feelings began to pour forth on the paper from me, I became clear that what was happening is I was remembering the last time I was in a waiting room when my dad had had knee replacement surgery, and because of complications ended up never leaving the hospital. So in that moment, my grief was resurrected at some deep level that had not healed yet. And it gave me this great opportunity to just write and to feel those sad feelings, that they weren't for my husband. They were for my dad. And eventually, as I wrote, I grew lighter and I felt better and clearer until finally the doctor came in and said my husband was fine. So the second way of expressing emotion that I'm going to share today is physically. And again, we want it to be expressed from the body. So to be able to release emotion that's in the body, which is the very deepest level, the origins of emotion is in the body. So to be able to do that, we need physical expression. So thinking this through in your mind doesn't work because that's circular thought and it just goes round and round and round. So it doesn't give you the same level of relief. And talking about your feelings is a physical process. When you are talking about it in present tense, like I'm feeling now, rather than talking about I felt then, you get a greater release. So when you start writing, I am feeling, That's what you want it to be. So again, back to the second technique, which is physical. We are allowing our body to move in whatever way it wants to express whatever feeling is there. And so now the feeling state and the body are interacting back and forth. So for instance, it may be that you're feeling really tight, wound, and so you let your body just express that just as fully as possible until you feel something different. And so maybe all of a sudden there is a shift in the body and you allow now the new feeling. So the new feeling may be a desire to move, to release that tension rather than being wound up. And you continue in your own process for yourself to keep expressing in physical form what you're feeling, or what you're feeling to take physical form. It goes both ways. This is done for you. It is personal expression. It's not to for the appearances, for anybody else to watch. So if you're doing this in a group or with other people, it works well to have everybody close their eyes because it's really an inner experience. However, I have witnessed when people do this, it can be very poignant and very emotional for the people who are watching when it's done from that deep heart place. And so remember now the two ways that you can release emotion from your body. The first one being immediately doing some uncensored writing with a complete feeling and putting pouring your feelings onto the paper. And the second is to take time to allow your body to move and express that feeling as also another way of allowing it to exit your body. So your feelings do not belong in your body. They're not meant to stay in your body. That's not how we were designed. We just haven't quite understood, how all of that works. So thank you for being with me, and I look forward to being with you again.